Actually, becoming redefining impact mechanisms to solve problems on the mobile web. So first, it's also my pleasure to welcome the first Japanese speaker of the afternoon. And Keigo, Imai-san has had a very interesting history. He's not only been doing web programming in OCaml, he's telling me he's also using the Koch theorem for proof embedded systems, and he's done Python calculus and Haskell in the past. So he's the perfect example of someone who has learned these tools in university and then goes on to really
interesting commercial applications of this as well. So please, welcome to the stage as well. I am Keigo Imai from Japan. And we came from here. So Nagoya, you know Nagoya? Thank you. and he or she is a salesperson, so they will sell us service, not a host, so that the problem doesn't work out if we have any audience. And there's also a big bad thing. It's cost. Of course, it is better by if we can sell software by ourselves, but we cannot afford that right now. And the second case. A notorious customer bigger than us says, deliver my software as soon as possible. shows you a picture or chart via some device. And in our case, that is smartphone. This is Android, but you may know also know iPhone. Firstly, their requirement is only to show a picture, not a static picture, on the mobile phone. But we propose, hey, why don't you don't we type to HTML5? So the specification or requirement changed to a dynamic chart, which is rather a challenge. Using HTML5 scroll by hand, and this is particularly important chat. This chat requires to shrink or expand automatically. So such complex animation is required in a reasonable speed. And in iPhone, there's not a lot of refresh support, so we must use CSS3 instead of HTML5. What is HTML5 and CSS3? HTML5 has many functionality, but what we use here is canvas, which can draw rectangle lines and letters and so on the and a part of this HTML5 contains a CSS3 initial feature which can show transform an HTML element in a thing or linear. Means when we do plugin or sharing or rotating features, and which also supports some animation. And this is used for scrolling and scaling. optimization technique on OCaml is available on also Ajax. This is important. Avoid polymorphic comparison, which is there's some values which site is known at that place, then from Ajax mobile to be in an efficient way. And so it avoids. And functional calling is in OCaml.js is much inefficient. So in the title, so because it is some for sharing. For sharing is a property function. So if you call some OCaml function very very title, then use just Inline JavaScript or more efficient JS. We achieve good performance and quality, and customer says we like such an excellent application. And until now, no bugs are reported. Then there are end users. And there's other lessons from this development. Lastly, not always OCaml is the best choice to develop some small snippets. When we develop this application, we firstly write code for snippets. For example, using CSS3 to check if the growing feature in a very short time. And this also reduces some pitfalls in the implementation. And this is this is my version of it on the Stack Overflow. There's some rich overlaps in the CSS animation. So I'm posting this artistically. But the answer after the project ended, and he says it's a long bug. So on that time, no one knows that bug. So I must make a welcome by myself. But this is difficult, yet. So if you try to develop a HTML5 application, then firstly, you can make a small example in object JavaScript is possible. And another is very important is one day, a big name asked us, hey, your demo is very good. Yes, thank you. This is your super marvelous OCaml technique. Then, I can read OCaml at all. I want to extend it by myself. Let me see. Then, no response. You know. That is a small one. So, as our lesson is done, more lessons. Firstly, you have your small subject in JavaScript, then proceed to OCaml. This is possible. And be cautious to say, this is written in OCaml. In the very first place, it's not so good. Or you should miss some opportunity. So, I will be a bit more technical about the working in the webinar. Not in Canvas, but some HTML5 feature requires continuous hashing, for example, SQL databases. It requires continuous hashing. I mean, if the browser, call back the continuation after it is done. That's very, very interesting use of condition and condition model in the web browser. But attention, this exhibits some concrete because that is such powerful condition model. Putting the combination in the timeout function and becomes first using this condition, then this condition. Very, very highly compliant for programming in debugging is become very difficult. So, I presented a few ways to utilize how we survive using function properties. And the first one is establish a good partnership with some places and the negotiation with against the short delivery time is also important to insist on function parameters. And your brains or your instruction program running is also a good choice. But also I said about serious but actually obvious dilemma. Function program running is not yet much of a resource. Some people may ask us to deliver some code and we are and our experience from Ocamljs and the HTML5 is also I probably. And this works pretty well script. Because everything is tight and there's really no errors. And same thing with the
figure it out.